ladies and gentlemen, Gungans and droids. I hope I didn't interrupt your evening or your slumber, but it's time to wake up! Because you and I have a brand new character that has been confirmed for Star Wars Galaxy of Heroes. Darth Talon is coming to Galaxy of Heroes, and she's meant to help out the Sith Triumvirate, and I think we can make some key deductions based off some confirmation that we've gotten earlier today. All of this news late this evening is coming straight from RSG. Links down below to their video. They did more of like a developer insights interview with the developers on Darth Talon, and she's supposed to be a super Sith loyalist, sacrificing herself in the place of a leader who might be killed off here. And we're going to take this a step further in a moment here. But I have clearance to let you guys know that tomorrow, roughly 12 hours from this video, 11 a.m., November 30th, Central Time, 9 a.m. Pacific Time, 12 p.m. Eastern Time, I also have a character reveal, as well as an exclusive rework reveal that you guys do not want to miss. It's a load of fun. Hope to see you guys there. But let me just tell you where we are right now, so you can maybe make a quick deduction on your own. We're going to roll some random gameplay. Do you have some scam quests? Roll that. Where are we right now? Kyle Katarn. We already have him. Cash Spendar. We already have them. Let me put some links in the top right-hand corner if you want to see the gameplay for them. Darth Talon, officially confirmed. That's the third one. Well, the fourth one, I think we can kind of fill in the dots a little bit. As you guys know, there was a little accidental slip up on the apps, or apparently Mara Jade is coming. That hasn't been fully confirmed by CG themselves, but you know, I'm sure time will tell, ladies and gentlemen, Gungans and droids. So what in the heck is Darth Talon supposed to offer for Star Wars Galaxy of Heroes? Well, in case you don't know, let's actually, Gary, bring him back over. I'm sorry to interrupt you, Gary. Bring him back over here. In case you guys don't know, I'll be honest, I don't know much about Darth Talon because her presence was most in the form of reading materials rather than video games, and director of the video gaming division kind of says something. It's not the reading division around here. The most I really know about her is I know that George Lucas, when he was planning the sequels originally before Disney took over, he wanted the sequels to be about Darth Maul and Darth Talon, if my memory is correct. But if you want to learn more about her, she's in a ton of comics down below. I believe they're called the Legacy Comics down here. So a very popular character for people that are really into comic books and whatnot. But it's kind of odd that they're making her more in tune with the Sith Triumvirate. And through the developers testing, they say Sith Empire Trooper is going to be a good fifth character to throw in that slot. And they said a few things. Some I disagree with, some I do agree with. One thing I disagree with is originally they were designing Darth Talon, and they thought, all right, maybe Sith Eternal could use the help. But then they're like, Sith Eternal does not need the help. And I fully disagree. I think he definitely needs at least a little bit of help. He's definitely falling behind, especially after the great nerf of 2021 and Kenobi getting a buff up against Sith Eternal Emperor. He still does stuff, don't get me wrong, but definitely he's losing a bit of his edge. So I disagree with that. But what I do agree with what the developers said in their little dev interview is that the Sith Trumpet's falling out of favor, and I do agree about that. If you guys watch my streams, you'll hear me quite frequently say Sith Trumpet, Darth Treya, they're all right, team. They just don't feel as important in the game as they should. They were kind of important when they were able to counter Galactic Legends. Treya was helpful for countering Rey's Supreme Leader Kylo Ren before Darth Vader unfortunately got nerfed a long, long time ago. So I do agree that Sith Trumpet is probably one of the least legendary-ish feeling things in the game. Kenobi has a use, Han Solo has a strong use, Treya not so much, more for Geonosian and cleanup. And I think a raid character should probably have a higher level of use inside of this game. So apparently Cruel in Grand Arena, as you guys know a few moments ago, card in the top right hand corner, some controversial big changes, Squad Arena getting canceled, all the crystals moving over to Grand Arena. So now it makes more sense why they're creating Grand Arena focused teams, especially with the Omicrons. And my suspicious Sith trio with Darth Talon, she's getting an Omicron, and I'm assuming that's why it says Cruel inside of Grand Arena. Loyal Attacker, let's go ahead and read these real quick. So she's Dark Side Attacker, Sith. Loyal Attacker protects her Sith leader from defeat, sacrificing her own health in the process. Now again, not a full kit reveal, not even gameplay. I was actually surprised RC didn't have a full kit reveal or gameplay to show. I'm assuming that's going to be tomorrow or the day after perhaps, and then we're going to probably get her accessible on Thursday later on this week. And I know you guys are going to probably hop on over to see what she's all about. I don't know. The point I'm getting at is I don't know if she's going to be just for Sith Triumvirate lead. She's going to sacrifice herself for Treya, but from the way it looks, She's going to sacrifice herself for maybe if there's a Maul lead. Maybe if there is, oddly enough, maybe a Lord Vader or a Sith Eternal. We have to wait and see for the specifics of the kit, but I would really like to see how this works next, because the generality of Darth Talon, she's a super loyalist when it came to her role inside the comics, and she's a deadly Sith. It's stealth. She can gain 100% Terminator defeating an enemy via ordered assassination. Now, again, we don't know how this kit works. It sounds like there's going to be a status effect applied on someone. And if you kill that person, they're immediately going to get 100% Terminator. Sounds a little bit interesting. Again, no full kit reveal as now, but let me go ahead and summarize a couple other things that they mentioned here. And I think, actually, before we do that, I just want to remind you guys, it looks like this leak is indeed have at least some degree of truth right now, because they called out that Grand Arena is getting all the crystals and Squad Arena is getting its crystals removed, and there's a daily tournament type activity. So this leak that we broke down the other day seems like it is pretty legit. And if you actually go all the way down to the bottom of this post that we have here, it mentions that there's going to be a Darth Nihilus Ravager capital ship. And I think especially since they're creating this character, Darth Talon it is, to support the Sith Triumvirate, I think it's making more sense now more than ever that Darth Nihilus is probably going to get his Ravager down there. And I'm going to take it one step further. I think we might actually expect a rework for the Sith Triumvirate. That is complete speculation, but I think it definitely is a good degree of certainty that we're going to be getting a Darth Nihilus Ravager down the road. I don't know why, because we have enough capital ships. We're lacking actual ships to support the capital ships we already have in game. I digress. I'm sure they're going to probably find something to address that here. But anyways, let's go ahead and quickly just summarize a few things in that interview. Again, if you want to listen to the full thing, it's actually quite quick and it summarizes it pretty well. So I highly recommend go watch RSG if you want to see the full thing themselves. They said Darth Talon's meant to help out Sith Trio. Sounds like she worked with other Sith, as we saw off that little brief description. They say Sith Eternal does not need the help. I find that a little controversial. This is, I get worried when developers say this. But they claim that she's going to have high single target burst damage. And the last time I heard something like that, I was greatly disappointed. I'm looking at you, Omega. Quite a disappointing character. Probably the most disappointing character so far in 2021. The fifth slot, we kind of mentioned earlier, said Empire Trooper. They said you should work in that fifth slot pretty darn well. And I don't think that's going to be a hard sell. Yes, Sith Empire Trooper is nice with Darth Riven, but by no means is he an absolute necessity, especially now more than ever where we're getting all these counters to Darth Riven. No matter if you have a pre-taunting tank or not, I think depending on how the kit, the team might look like, especially in Grand Arena becoming so important, Sith Empire Trooper might have a superior use with Darth Trey. And funny enough, that was his first home when he came to Star Wars Galaxies. He was meant to help out Trey, and it looks like he's coming back home with the Sith Triumvirate, apparently, even though the Sith Empire is his home, but Treya kind of adopted him for a temporary amount of time before Darth Riven came around. Overall, that's all we pretty much got for the most part. They kind of talked more about an interview with their past for the comics, how they're really excited to bring him some inspiration for the design of the character, as well as some comics that they read about her. Overall, sounds like an interesting character. I've been looking forward to a new Sith character. It's been quite a while, although I am a little bummed that Sith Eternal is not going to be directly helped out of Darth Talon, but my hope and prayer is that Sith Triumvirate might get better down there, and maybe even a rework of Darth Nihilus is indeed getting a Ravager within the next few months, like that alleged leak is suggesting. And maybe that will indirectly, in the end, if the Sith Triumvirate's a more functional team, maybe it'll indirectly help out the Sith Eternal as well. So that's going to wrap it up for today. Thank you guys so much for coming out this late at night. And if you're someone that missed the roll call while you're asleep, don't worry, we're open 25/8. So think about it. When you get here, you're never really late. So let that sit there for a moment. I'll see you guys tomorrow for my own exclusive character reveal, as well as a rework that might actually surprise you. And it's going to be a lot of fun to watch. Like, comment down below. I'd say dislike, but YouTube took away the dislike button if you didn't like this at all. But hey, we never have opposition around here. Everyone already always loves our stuff. But you know what I also love? Is our good old saying where we always say, dang, it's great to be in the Empire today.